At this stage, with all centers solved and all edges paired, we can continue solving the cube just like a 3x3. We just need to move both inner layers together, and by doing that, we avoid break apart any center block or any edge block. Unfortunately, using our 3x3 knowledge to solve the 4x4 Rubik's Cube revenge will bring us not one, but four possible outcomes. Congratulations, you fully solved the cube. You solved the whole cube, except for one single edge block that remains flipped. This error is known as edge parity, and you can use this algorithm to fix it. You solved the whole cube, except for these two corners switched. This error is known as corner parity, and you can use this algorithm to fix it. Well, our biggest nightmare, we end up with both edge and corner parity at the same time. Now, the purpose of this video is to show you guys that there are less complicated solutions than those long and complex algorithms so difficult to memorize. Let's take a look at them. Now, at this stage, with a cube scrambled just like a 3x3, we are going to figure out if there is, or not, edge parity. And if there is, fix it, without the use of any complex algorithms. So, how does it work? We are going to check the orientation of all 12 edge pieces, and then count all the ones with a good orientation. And if we end up with an odd number, then it means that we have an edge parity error. On the other hand, if we end up with an even number, it means that we are edge parity free. Let's start with the procedure. Choose a front and a back color. Let's choose white in the front and yellow in the back. Now choose two side colors. Let's choose orange and red for the sides. Finally, keep the blue on top and the green on bottom, and just ignore them. Now, starting with the white front facing you, count as good edges the ones with white or yellow facing you, and the ones with orange or red facing aside. And we have three good edges in the front face. This white facing you, this yellow facing you, and this orange facing aside. Now, flip the cube and bring the back face into the front. With the yellow center facing you, again the same procedure. Count as good edges the ones with white or yellow facing you, and the ones with red or orange facing aside. And we have two good edges in the back yellow face. This orange facing aside, and this white facing you. Now, note that this red is also correct, but this counts only as one good edge. So, we have counted five good edges so far. Next, the side faces. For the side faces, we are going to count only the edge on the top and the edge on the bottom. We already count the left and white edges before. Starting with the orange center facing you, count as good edges the ones with orange or red facing you, and the ones with white or yellow facing aside. And we have two good edges in the orange side. This red facing you and this white facing aside. So we have counted 7 blue edges so far. And finally, the other side face. Now, with the red center facing you, let's again count only the top and bottom edges. Count as good edges the ones with orange or red facing you, and the ones with white or yellow facing aside. And there are none. They are both dead edges. So we have counted a total of 7 good edges. And 7, it's an odd number. And now we know that we have an edge parity error. Let's then move on to the next step and solve this edge parity. The edge parity on a 4x4, that can never happen on a 3x3, is decided by the number of turns you do when you scramble your cube, adding the number of turns you do solving all the centers. So basically, to solve the edge parity error, you just need to do this. Break up the centers with a quarter of a turn, and then rebuild them all back, starting on the left face. But if we do this randomly, we will mess up 4 DEDGES already paired. Okay, I'm going to show you a very simple sequence of moves that will replace the centers without messing up the edge pieces. We are going to move 4 center blocks in sequence, starting with the white, followed by the blue, and ending with the yellow. The green center will come out solved automatically. With the white center on top and the green facing you, turn the right inner layer down 90 degrees. Move the white squares to the left inner layer. Slide the white squares on top down to the front and move them to the right inner layer. Bring back the white squares on bottom to fix the white center. Now, turn the cube down 90 degrees and let's repeat the same sequence to the blue squares. Move the blue squares to the left inner layer. Slide the blue squares on top down to the front and move them to the right inner layer. Bring back the blue squares on bottom and fix the blue center. Again, turn the cube down 90 degrees and let's fix the yellow center. But this time keep the yellow squares on the front face on the right inner layer. Instead, move the yellow squares on top from the left to the right inner layer. And from there, slide them down to the front face. Now, move them to the left inner layer and bring back the yellow squares on bottom to fix the yellow center. And this is it. We rebuilt all the centers without breaking any edge piece. And now that we know that we are edge parity free, you can continue solving your cube using your 3x3 knowledge. Unfortunately, at the very end, you can still find this situation. PLL, also known as corners parity. Let's solve it on the last step.